Happy Vegan New Year, Master.
Happy Vegan New Year, Master.
Happy New Year, all of you.
Master, we love you so much.
Yeah, I love you too.
I love you, Master.
I love you, Master.
Each and every star that you see in the night, they are one world. And even invisible planets, they also need help. Not just physical planets.
The original world is vibrant, is lively, is colorful, is creative, is active, and happy, happy.
When I enter eternity, the mind is still left behind in the time and space zone of this world. There are many class, angel like A class, B class, C class, B class. People say when there's a new moon, you can wish something and your wish come true. Whenever I see new moon, I wish everyone would reconsider peaceful solutions. Reconsider vegan diet. Humans should change, try to be good things, and try to be forgiven and merciful.
Hello, Master.
Yeah.
It has been 3 years since Supreme Master Television stopped broadcasting. And sometimes people still ask about it. They miss watching Master's lecture and the good news every day and also enjoying the positive vibration. Will there be any future plan to relaunch Supreme Master Television?
I don't know yet. I don't think so, but I know. It's so much work. Right now, I can't help you, you see?
Yes, Master.
Not just because of that, but I plan to do it just 3 years because we are a spiritual group.
There are so many television and different types of media already, you know. All we have to do is just add more educational subjects such as environmental protection, climate change, reduction, high moral standards, encourage us caring more for the needy, etc. Then this should be sufficient.
Yes, Master.
Airing or printing more of these priorities for our world.
Of course, ours are the best because we only
yes, Master, it was.
Do the best. Yeah, and we keep benefits inside out, spiritually, physically, emotionally. Environmentally, mentally, psychologically, all kind of benefits that we give through television. But you see, I have to let everybody meditate because when we are doing television, everybody works a lot. Not just you group in the TV center, but everybody else around. Not everybody, but a lot of people are helping hands. We do translations, to hunt the news, and you know, subtitle and camera and computer, all kind of things. Everybody has to spend a lot of time.
Yes, Master.
But I don't know if people even listen to anything that I say. Or we're just wasting our time. Precious time. Meditation time. Just not informing the world the things that they should know or they should have informed themselves. But nowadays, I'm happy to see some of the television that even advertise for vegetarian food, you know.
Yes.
And now and then, I saw some of the hosts on TV say, I'm vegetarian or I'm vegan.
Wow.
Or introducing vegan and vegetarian group or vegetarian food and all that, you know, more than before. And I hope they do it more and more until completely get that. And not advertising for religion thing anymore, which is really disgusting. How can anyone nowadays, in the face of danger of our planet and climate change and all that, still advertising meat and eat this bloody thing, put it in your mouth? when people see animals, they think the animals are dirty and all that. But they put it in their mouth. They don't think it's dirty. How can?
Yes, true, Master.
How can it be so? I mean, paradoxically like that, yeah. Even they say, oh, it's just an animal, or the dog is dirty, the pigs are rolling in their poo and pee and everywhere. The animals, they say they are just animals, it's just dirty. But your mouth, so precious and clean, and you put this dirty thing in your mouth, and don't think about it. Nowadays, people like that, how can it be? So, you know what I mean? People have to change. Otherwise, 2014 is the hottest year on record. And still raising animals, raising more methane gas, and then robbing all the world resources just to eat the dirty animal thing. To put that so-called dirty animal piece of bloody thing in their mouth. If it's something dirty, you don't put it in your mouth, no?
Yes, true, Master.
All right. Sorry.
A planet is in trouble.
We are so, so close to the red line that perhaps we may wake up tomorrow and find that there's nothing to save after all.
The issue of livestock and meat is not only a diet issue, it is an environmental issue.
The destruction of the environment by using large areas of land to feed cattle or pigs is actually taking up an awful lot of land that could be used to produce far more protein if it was vegetable protein. Making animal protein is wasteful.
It is creating a lot of greenhouse gas emissions.
50% of our national greenhouse gas emissions come from the agricultural sector, primarily in the form of methane.
The United Nations in particular, but also other organizations, have encouraged people to give up meat.
Unless we change our food choices, nothing else matters, because it is meat that is destroying most of our forests. It's meat that pollutes the waters. It is meat that is creating disease, which leads to all our money being diverted to hospitals. So it's the first choice for anybody who wants to save the earth.
It will, of course, mean new kinds of consumer behavior and lifestyles. And all of us, government, business, civil society, individuals, all of us have a major part to play. I have no doubt that this is a challenge to which we can all rise.
The earth we leave for our children must be safeguarded. Let us choose hope, founded on humanitarian values. Let us be determined to place mankind at the heart of our priorities.
Well, Master, we just want to tell you that Supreme Master Television was a really precious gift you have given to the world, and it was a privilege for us all around the world who were a part of it in any way.
Good. I'm glad. I'm glad you think that way. And I also thank you again and again, all of you who are involved in this directly or indirectly, and your group there or outside. But number one, we have to go back to deep meditation. Okay?
Yes,
because,
Master.
When you come to initiate with me, I promise you heaven and God. Okay?
Yes, Master.
Yes, Master.
I have to deliver that.
Thank you so
let
much.
Let you meditate to find God and heaven. And if we can continue with the religion or not, it also depends on collective karma of the world, eh? Yeah.
I see, Master.
And another thing is, I don't have enough time now to work with you, because I noticed that before, whenever I'm busy doing something and I don't have time to read to read all the scripts or edit them, then I saw many mistakes, many things we put on air, for example. And at that time, I even have more time than now. I wasn't in New York to I meditate a lot, but it wasn't that intensive. And I could stop or not. You see, but right now, I have even less time. to help me out to edit all the scripts that have to go out into the world to benefit people. We have to be very careful. We cannot do it. Of course, nobody realizes what we do. Nobody thinks that any mistake, but I know. Because for the world standard, maybe you are good or excellent. Even. For me, no.
I understand.
I mean, the program you air. That's why you saw many, I cut before, cut off, yeah?
Yes.
Cut off.
Yes,
or take away or everything. Even my talk, sometimes I don't have time to get, and then you edit something. Oh, when I heard it, it's bad. But in one part or one section of the talk, you edit too much. It's become like it. I did, I that, I do this, I do that, I talk this. I like 100 I's in one section. Sounds terrible. You see?
Understand.
For example. You see, so different reasons like that. That's why. Okay?
Yes, Master.
Now I think we should leave the other television that should air more about the climate change and about the benevolent way of life. And they should continue. That's their job, you know.
Yes, Master. Speaking of the media, in France just recently there was a tragedy at the Charlie Hebdo magazine headquarters and some journalists even lost their life. Master, could you please share some words about this tragic event?
It's really a very sad event. I was very sad for many days afterwards. And I pray for all the people, the concerned people who were injured in that event and around that event, the injured person to recover fast. It's like the injured person everywhere in the world. And I pray for all the people who died in the Paris tragic event to live forever, reconcile in heaven, and rest in peace. People should know that the journalists are not to be blamed because they are taught from journalism to believe provocative and sensational news, true or not true, regardless. And some journalists use more of this method, others use less. But some journalists don't use this method at all. If their type of work doesn't require.
True.
And then wait for response from the target, either group or person, to either come to face them for correction or pay to have a redo of a corrected and better version. Unfortunately, some people do not know how to play this kind of game. Or they don't have any means to do so. So they end up at the losing end, which is sometimes tragic.
Yes, Mr.
And even if the items or the article has been redone for a better version or more corrected version, even then the damage is already done because not everyone will see the second version, the improved, better version. If you beat somebody up physically, maybe he recover, maybe he doesn't recover. It depends on how grave the injury is. But to damage someone's reputation, it's difficult for them to recover from the public's opinion. So we don't know which one's worse, really. Or in some case, unfortunately, sadly, the journalists themselves pay a dear price. Very dear price, even sometimes with their lives.
Understand.
So we must correct the journalistic education system. The media are the public eyes and ears. They should stick to reporting truth. Just report the true news, like some of their straightforward, excellent, great journalists. Even though it reports that sensational news or negative news attracts people more, attracts readers or viewers more. We should just choose to do what we think is right. like everything else in life, not just women.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, master.
I know some individuals who are journalists, which is the job don't pay well. Especially since nowadays we have internet and television and telephone. So they just went out and did some other jobs instead, or did extra jobs. As long as we earn honest living, it doesn't matter what kind of job we do. But we do need journalists, you know, to know the news in the world and to be informed of weather forecast and all kind of things. The journalists are very useful to people.
Yes, master.
Just in some cases, it's not very favorable. I'm very, very sorry. This world is not very favorable all the time. Not to everybody, not to all people, not to all beings. As I said again and again, humans have to change to more noble standards, more benevolent, more forgiving, more tolerant, more truthful to all, not just humans, but all inhabitants. Animals on this planet when we will have paradise on earth.
Yes, we pray that all humans will soon learn the way of benevolence and peace. And regarding the media, the ones who had written bad things about you, things which are totally not true, of course, what did you do, Master? How did you react?
Well, I didn't react at all. I don't play games. You know, some papers, some television, some radio, some numbers. Some I only heard about. I didn't really know. I didn't really read. But I always just let it go.
I see, Master.
First I thought, well, let them sell, let them profit even for me. But I felt sad as how someone would do this kind of thing to someone else who never offended them in any way and without even knowing each other at all. I felt that at the time, but I always let it go. I never play games. And sometimes some of the journalists came to me and say, oh, their newspaper is not doing well. Some of them in a hard time. And then I helped them financially. And then whatever. They print. I didn't even know. I didn't even read.
Understand, Master.
And sometimes some televisions or radios invite me to their station and ask me something and then ask the people to call in negative remarks and then they told me, the television told me, oh, come back again next week and then we ask other people to call in with more positive things. I never did that either. I just pray that heaven forgive them, whoever done harm to me in any way, I just pray to heaven to forgive them. That's all. That's all I reacted, all by myself. I never do anything.
Yes, Master.
And sometimes some of the papers have written something very negative about me. And then afterwards they came and say, you must give me so much. You know, several times.
Wow.
You must give me so much, or else it could be worse, would be terrible. I just didn't answer. I did not give anything. I did give before when they say they're in trouble. But when some other papers wrote something bad about me, and then afterwards they came and asked for money, or you will die.
Wow.
That is the exact word that they use. I just didn't respond, and I did not give. I felt so indignant just to go arguing with anybody and to prove that they are untruthful. Or to have to buy my reputation. So I didn't say anything, if you want to know. I never wanted to bribe people in my life. I would feel very, very indignant if I did that. If I do that.
Oh, Master, that should have never happened to you.
Oh, that doesn't matter, really, because these are considered just small numbers
no matter how many. There are many in the good media who support us, and I'm very, very grateful for their valuable friendship.
True, Master. They are. We are also thankful for that. Going to the next topic, we would like to talk about the song that you sang during last conference. It was called Untitled. It was, Master, it was so beautiful. It was like nothing we have ever heard before. And we even uploaded it in online and produced it into complimentary CDs for our association members for the holidays. And everyone just loved your song. They said it was the best Christmas gift they could ever have. Everyone felt so grateful to you, Master. Some people even held a party celebration with candlelight to listen to the song. So my question, Master, is, was this celestial song brought down from the original universe? Is there a reason why you were inspired to compose it?
Oh, my God. Such a big deal, really?
Yeah, it was beautiful, Master.
Oh, thank you. But I was feeling so shy because my voice wasn't up to it. At that time, when I first ever heard sing it out loud alone by myself, it was really beautiful. Even I say that. But when I sing it to you, it's not as beautiful as that. But I'm glad you guys like it.
Master, we love it so much.
Okay, it's good. Thank you. I just sit in my meditation, and then I have the urge to sing it out. I said, and it comes out as is. I didn't change anything.
Wow, it was beautiful.
And then I wrote it down, and I sing it to you as a gift last year.
Yeah, it was, thank you so much, Master. It was the most beautiful heavenly voice we have ever heard.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Wow.
It vibrates beautifully, beautifully, Master.
Wow, if you could have heard me the first time, then I would accept that compliment. I really would. First time, I think it should come out, you know.
Wow, Master. This song, did you name this song Entitled because it was too beautiful for any worldly title to fit it?
No, I just said Entitled because I didn't think of any title. So I just say it has no title. You can put any title if you want, but why need title? No?
True.
Yeah, or just say Untitled or no title. Or no need title.
Thank you again, Master, for this song. It's a very beautiful gift.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. I'm really... I thank you.
Thank you, Master.
I wish that you... I could record it when I first sing it. But, of course, I never thought about that at that time. And I also had no recorder with me at that time. And even if I could record it, probably the voice would not be the same. Anyway... If you enjoy it, then thank God.
Yes, Master. Yes. Thank you again.
Yeah, but I was kind of shy about it. I know my voice wasn't as good. Perhaps because I compared to the first time, that's why.
I see.
Okay, any more questions?
It was beautiful for us, Master.
Oh, wow. All right. What in Vietnam we say, Mẹ hả? Con khang hay á? That means when the mother sings, all the children clap.
Our mother has always a beautiful voice.
Thank you.
And Master, the flautist who played the flute accompaniment for your song, she also remarked that your voice was just so very beautiful that she asked if she could listen to you sing when recording her part.
What?
Yes. And Master, you said that the songs from Loving the Silent Tears will uplift the world for generations. What effect will Master's new song, Untitled, have on the world, especially since you sang it personally? Will those who listen to it be uplifted much more quickly?
You know, every positive spoken word has... So, if something positive, of course it will affect people, huh?
Yes, Master.
No, that depends on him, or depends on the person. And if you speak positive words with your heart as well, then of course the effect is even stronger.
stuff. That is logical, okay?
Yes. Yes, Master. Thank you, Master. Your song, Untitled, was one of the most beautiful songs I've ever heard in my entire life. Yes, Master.
You didn't hear much.
Yes, it was so good, Master.
Thank you, my love.
Also, in The Real Love and Loving the Silent Tears musical, there were many great songs, but the two that you wrote, On the Riverbank and Talking to a Stone Buddha, they were to me the most touching. Could you possibly explain to us how you write music so beautifully? Do the melodies come from above or come from within?
Well, I just am inspired and do it on the spot most of the time. Most of my poems are like that. It will flow out. You can call it from above or from inside, from outside, whatever. It just came out spontaneously. Just like now, when you're asking me, I'm answering you spontaneously. I didn't write anything down to answer you. Or maybe some of the notes here, you know, like how much karma, how much spiritual point, but it's from my diary, but the rest I just came out, you know, spontaneously. I guess the need of the time. It's like you need me to answer you. When you need it, then I'll do it for you. So when, maybe when the world needs that song, then the song comes out. Maybe it helps.
Oh, I see. Thank you so much, Master. Whenever we hear you sing, our hearts rejoice. Your songs are a priceless jewel for our world and countless future generations. Thank you again for singing to us in the last conference, Master.
Thank you, Master.
My pleasure. I try to believe you because you sanctify precepts. You won't hide. If you tell me it's good, then I believe you. Otherwise, I didn't think they were too good.
Master? Would you happen to have any other compositions from the original universe you could share with us?
No time at the moment. But if it comes out again, then of course I will share with you. Bye. Right now, not.
Thank you, Master.
I guess you don't have enough time at the moment or something. I'm too busy with the meditation. Because it's not just a 15-hour, you know. Apart from work, I have to cook for the big dog because he doesn't like to eat dog food. He thinks it's a human. So he just likes to eat the food that I cook for him. And if I put two side by side, then he would eat just the food I cook. If I keep, you know, like I put just a little bit of dog food together with the food I cook, he would leave it. He won't eat the dog food.
Ah.
Even if I put just, and then if I say, okay, if I put just a very little cooked food, and then he's hungry, he will eat the rest of the dog food. No, if I put just a little bit of my cooked food, then he just eats that little bit. And then he won't eat anything else the whole day, even if I put it there, he won't eat. He will. So I cook for him, and then I have to clean up and then, you know, wash up and take care of him. I take care of him personally, you know, and then every day I have to, like, set down his bed, and clean his bed, and his blanket, you know, put his blanket away to wash, and then change the sheets and stretch it, and change the blanket, and clean him up, you know, play with him a little bit, talk to him, pet him, and talk to him in his dog language or without dog language.
Wow, Master has to do every single thing yourself.
Yeah, I have to. I clean and wash like a Cinderella here. I don't complain. I'm just telling you that I may be busy. And it's not just a meditation teaching time, which is much more than before. I mean, apart from normal meditation, like, you know, like initiated planning, method. Apart from that, last time, when I tell you just some 15 minutes and all that sort of connection with yourself, this time, not this time, long hours, huh? different project, understand?
Yes, Master.
Yes, Master.
And then, And then before that, the same with the Osho connection before meditation, I had to prepare. Not just 1 hour, before that. I mean, the days before, I had to begin already preparing myself.
Wow.
To make sure my body is fit enough for that, number one. And then I had to do research, to meditate, special to research on where this location will be and what hour that location will be open for me and how long I have to sit there. Not 1 second more, not 1 second less. You understand us, yes?
Yes, Master.
So, takes a lot of time and effort. It's not just the sitting. Sitting is the easier part. And even already the time now, it's stretching like it's thinking. It's very exasperating for the mind and the body.
Oh, I see.
What to do? Okay? So that's why I don't think of poetry or songs or anything at the moment. Too busy.
Understand, Master.
Have to do research, okay? And then have to translate the cosmic power into the agreeable power so that my body can absorb it. And then have to translate the cosmic term of that power into English, approximately, so that my mind, my body, the cells, will understand that and will catch it without harm and without wasting. Do you understand?
Yes, Master.
It's not just, okay, now, 9 o'clock, go to 3 o'clock, go to. It's not like that. I have to plan in advance.
I see. Wow.
Yeah, yeah.
Thank you, Master, for sharing with us.
Now you know. And then, even then, sometimes my body revolves. Like, for example, yesterday, last night, after eating, or even not eating, I have heartburn, just so.
Oh, no.
And then, I wrote it here, again, heartburn, and apple is good.
Oh.
It's one of the tips for you.
Thank you, Master.
If you have heartburn or chest pain, I said heartburn, maybe just my case, I don't know if it works for you. I have nothing, so I just eat an apple. I feel like I should eat an apple, and I know it will help me, and then it did help.
Oh, thank goodness.
Okay. I hope I'm clear enough to you.
Yes, thank you, Master.
Okay. So if we do Supreme Master Television now, even if I have enough money and manpower, I still will not be sure to do it, because I don't have time to help you to sort out what's good and what's not to air.
Understand, Master.
Because I am responsible as much as you are for whatever we put out there. You see what I mean?
Yes, Master.
All right.
We understand. Thank you, Master.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Master, earlier we were speaking about your wonderful songs and poetry, and there's actually been some exciting things happening regarding that. Thousands of people are getting in touch with your poetry now, Master. We are reaching out to centers and also Loving Huts and Initiates restaurants to hold Loving the Silent Tears screening events for the public. One screening?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah,
And one screening had an audience of 1,400 people, and another center screened at a 500-seat auditorium, but they still had to add in a lot of extra temporary chairs just to accommodate everyone.
Wow.
Yes, and another small city had almost double the expected turnout that they sat in the aisles, Master.
Oh,
yes.
Sorry.
And in the interviews after the show, you can see the people, the members of the public, tearing up with emotion. They said that the show was so meaningful and purifying, and they really love Master's deep lyrics, like loving the silent tears more than the diamonds of the world, take each other's hand. They said that the words from your poems, like, stay with them.
Wow.
Yes, and in fact,
at one screening with nearly 700 attendees, the people said they've never seen such a wonderful video in their lifetime. And Master, wow. Several people even asked for initiation after that.
Wow. Whose idea? That's a good idea. Whose idea? Your guy's idea.
Your blessings just inspire them to share this with the world. And we've also been reaching out to...
Also what? He's thinking for me.
Yes, Master. We've also been reaching out to the Loving Huts, other restaurants, and the centers to encourage them to screen the musical for the public out there. And some centers have been starting to do the screenings on their own.
Yeah, good idea. Thank you.
Oh, thank you, Master.
Thank you. Oh, we'll do it. We have a good idea. Thank you.
Yes, your inspiration, Master.
We have to think for it.
Yes, and also, Master, with these screenings going on, the media... In more than one case, the media approached the screening organizers because they wanted to pre-announce the event on their own. And so people seem to really be embracing God's uplifting power at this time.
Good for them. Good for the world.
Yes. And Master, there's some other good news we'd like to share from around the world, if you'd like.
Please. I like to hear.
One example is there's some very nice news that has come out of the recent COP20, which was this past December in Peru, for the climate master. Actually, the United Nations, the Secretary General Ban Ki-moon, and two other officials, they prepared a vegetarian dish for a sustainable cooking demonstration. And it was supposed to be a very famous native Peruvian fish dish, but they substitute the fish for mushrooms instead. And
they should know that we Loving Food have vegan fish and it tastes delicious.
Yes, yes, Master.
Wow, you know when we have the Supreme Master Television, we forgot to advertise Loving Food. I have company for Loving Food. We make food. Like vegan fish, it looks like fish and tastes beautiful. And vegan shrimp and all that, we didn't advertise all that, right?
Right, Master.
In some of my cooking, I put some vegan shrimp there. At that time, because I was abroad, I wasn't in Taiwan, the company is in Taiwan, and I didn't have enough material with me. I didn't have enough food from the company with me. I guess that's why we didn't have it. Other companies don't have this, you know. I mean,
right.
In Europe or America, they don't have. The Loving Food have this beautiful, look alike fish. It's delicious. Maybe you could take some picture and put up on our internet so people know that they are sustaining. It's good.
Yes, Master.
Oh, Mr. Ban Ki-moon, if you come to my house, and we cook that real fish. And we cook for him.
Oh, I think he'd love that.
I mean, real vegan food dishes don't have to cook sticky with mushrooms. Mushrooms don't look mushrooms, they taste like it's beautiful. You know, it don't taste like fish, it just tastes beautiful.
Yes, Master. And actually, the chefs that prepared the meal were very famous chefs within Peru.
Wow, okay. Wow. Mr. Ban Ki-moon and Mr. Al Gore and some other big people. They even went on the demonstration march, huh?
Oh, yes, Master.
Yeah. For climate change, demanding more solution, more practical solution to stop climate change. They even went down and took themselves, I guess. Yeah, I saw that on the internet. I was very touched. If you ever see them or how you can get in touch with them, please tell them. I thank them from the bottom of my heart for being such an exemplary leader. At least Mr. Al Gore, you know, the former vice president, and
yes.
Mr. Ban Ki-moon. I think maybe, what is the actor name again? The actor there. Some famous people. I heard that DiCaprio. Yeah.
Oh, Leonardo DiCaprio, Master?
Yeah, I heard that he is also... bringing the ground to Christ.
Yes, Master. He actually produced a film on climate change, a documentary.
Yeah. You see, everybody is on the boat right now. It's probably rolling back, and people in the media should help to stop the climate change by broadcasting more positive approach to that and more environmentally friendly projects.
Even the president of COP20, who's the Peruvian Minister of the Environment, his name is Manuel Polgar Vidal, and also the Executive Secretary of the United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change, or UNFCCC, Cristiana Figueres, they also participated. And so altogether, they really, really sent a clear message to the delegates about eco-friendly eating, Master.
Good for them. Thank you. Thank them so much. I'm grateful to these people. Yeah, the leaders should make a sample. You know, like Mr. Benjamin and Al Gore. They are vegetarian or vegan now. And they should send more messages
than most people. These people, they have high positions in the world.
And their world is powerful.
That's true, Master.
I'm very grateful that you do that. Like Bill Clinton, like Ken Deegan, a lot.
My name's Kenneth Williams. I'm the world's first vegan bodybuilder champion and national spokesperson. The 21st century athlete. If he wants to move further in his and her development, they're going to have to come to grips with eating properly.
We have the power to really, you know, imagine the future and to affect it if we want to. So
I believe we need to treat all life with incredible respect.
I mean, every decision that we can make every day is going to make a difference to the planet. And
vegan diet, everybody wins, really. All the earthlings win on that one.
Shakyamuni Buddha, Jesus Christ, St. Francis of Assisi, Leonardo da Vinci, Shania Twain, Leo Tolstoy, Albert Einstein, Alicia Silverstone, Tobey Maguire, Joaquin Phoenix, Pamela Anderson. What do these distinguished people of the past and present have in common? They represent the circle of vegetarian and vegan elite and some of the most gifted and accomplished people in the world.
We have to follow what Mahatma Gandhi said, be the change you want to see in the world, then we have to start with ourselves. And one way that we can make a major difference is to reduce our meat consumption.
It's a win-win-win situation. It's good for the environment, it's good for people, it's good for animals.
10 billion farm animals are killed every single year in America, and that's 1 million animals per hour. That's astounding. 1 million animals per hour are slaughtered for food. That really disturbs me.
So considering all these aspects, it's better to switch to vegetarianism, which will bring back nature's harmony and has a purifying effect.
They are some of the countless noble examples of compassion and wisdom. So keep in good company with the Noble Circle of Vegetarian and Vegan Elite. And the list goes on. Please visit www.suprememastertv.com/VE for further club list and info. Choose veggie and join the club.
And the head of the UNFCCC, Christiana Figueres, she also visited the Loving Hut booth at the COP20 Master. And she said that she knew of our association and what we do, and she thanked us very much for coming many times to the COPs.
Oh, really? Wonderful.
And also the former First Lady of Peru, Pilar Nores de Garcia, and the mayor of the capital city, Lima, Susana Villarin, who is mostly vegetarian. They also came by the booth and tasted our food, and they both expressed keen interest in being vegan for the planet.
Next time, remember, tell them to bring some fish and shrimp, you know, the vegan shrimp, vegan fish from Loving Hut. I'll tell them to send some, okay?
Yes, Master, they will all enjoy it. We're very sure about that.
Well, there will be more enjoyment for them, so that people know that they will miss nothing when they become vegan. We have vegan cheese, delicious, vegan fish, vegan shrimp, vegan ham, vegan burgers, vegan chicken, vegan nuggets, vegan, whatever.
Vegan, yes, Master, everything.
Yeah, even just in my own small company like that, we produce so many things. Vegan mayonnaise, you know, delicious and fragrant. Taiwan people, they are so lucky.
Yes, Master.
Yeah.
And the U.S. ambassador to Peru, Brian Nichols, he spent time to talk, and all these dignitaries just loved receiving the gifts of Master's books and DVDs that were given to them.
What kind of DVD did you give? What kind of book?
Master's teachings books, Crisis to Peace was also given. Loving the Silent Tears, the DVD.
Yes, okay.
Yes, and they show great appreciation for all that, Master.
Okay, I hope they enjoy and have take time to read or to look at them.
Yes,
it
Master.
Probably help them to relax and to think of what's the best thing to do for themselves and the planet. Absolutely. Thank you. Thank you all of you for all this effort. Yes, thank you.
Actually, the Loving Hut booth was really a crowded hotspot there for the public and also for the media. And there were long lines of people lined up for tasting the beautiful vegan food.
But did they have what kind of food there? That's the thing. Did they have worthy food for them or just...
It was Loving Hut food, Master, so I'm sure it was just delicious.
Thousands of sandwiches, sushi, summer rolls and desserts were served to everyone, from the UN ministers to the NGO staff, journalists, and even the security guards and police and military officers. And on the last day, Master, this one police officer and a security guard told our people, "Because of you, I've become vegan."
Okay, but I don't know, Loving Hut have vegan fish or not, or vegan shrimp or not. I have vegan shrimp, but I think they do. but vegan fish, I don't remember. You see, the problem is I don't go to Level Hood myself. I only once or twice because I don't live near. Mostly I don't live near any Level Hood at all.
Yeah.
I live in mountain or, you know, river or forest area. I have to go there to meditate. And not because the mountain forest, but because the connection is there. So I have to go. And the Level Hood are mostly in the city, you know. So I don't have chance. I used to taste all the Level Hood food before they come out. I have to taste them first, you know, to see okay or not okay. But I'm not sure if they keep the food that I tasted and say okay, or they change them, depends on the location, country. Well, I did hope that they had really worthy food to offer to all these distinguished people who came to COP 20, right? Yeah.
Yes, Master. Well, it seems that it was very popular, with long lines of people lining up to taste the food. And even after the food was gone, people still hung around the booth and were talking about the vegan diet and also discussing Master's teachings.
Okay. Good for the camera.
Yes, Master.
We should do more of these kind of booths everywhere so people can taste and understand more about vegan diet. Which is good for the world and good for them.
Yes. The media, they also interviewed the booth and they aired and printed reports about the vegan answer for climate change. And, of course, Master, these are the solutions that you have been advocating since many, many years ago.
Yeah. It's just, even though it seems too little for my life, but it's better than nothing.
Yes. Master is.
I see the media change more now. They must even advertise vegetarian vegan food on TV.
Yes, that's right, Master.
And Gwyneth Paltrow, she even advertises for one of the vegetarian food brands.
Oh,
Gwyneth
really?
Gwyneth Paltrow, the great movie star.
Actress, yes, Master.
Yeah, she even does that. On her own name, on reputation, too. Yeah.
Yes, Master, great. It's also very encouraging to hear that His Holiness Pope Francis is also speaking out on climate change these days on both moral and scientific grounds. And he's calling on world leaders right now to be more courageous at the next COP. And he actually will be soon publishing a formal message to be delivered to Catholics all over the world, urging them to take action on climate change as an obligation to protect Mother Earth.
To be vegan?
To take action on climate change, Master, to protect Mother Earth.
What action could be better than vegan?
Yes, Master.
It's even saying in the Bible, the first thing, you know.
Yes.
God makes all the herbs and the fruits and the vegetables of you, that shall be your food. God doesn't say, I make animals to be your food. I don't remember anything like that in the Bible, except for, you know, vegetarian is your food. You know, vegan, yeah.
Yes, Master.
Yeah, and also say you should not be among meat eater and wine drinker, alcohol drinker. Yeah. Should not be among, not to talk about, should be one yourself, you see?
Yes, Master.
You should not be among meat eater and wine drinker. Not even be among them. The Bible says so clearly.
It was very clear.
I wonder how any Christian would miss that kind of symbol. And even God says, don't kill sea goats and sea ox. You make offering to me, because then your hands will be full of blood. I will not forgive you. I will not hear your prayer. I will turn my head away. It's so clear. I wonder why any Christian, or how any Christian would miss them.
Vegetarianism in the Bible. And God said, behold, I have given you every plant-yielding seed which is upon the face of all the earth, and every tree with seed in its fruit, you shall have them for food. and to every beast of the earth, and to every bird of the air, and to everything that creeps on the earth. Everything that has a breath of life, I have given every green plant for food. And it was so. Genesis, Holy Bible.
And the Lord God commanded the man, saying, "You may freely eat of every tree of the garden." Genesis, Holy Bible.
Even as the green herb have I given you all things, but flesh with the life thereof, which is the blood thereof, shall ye not eat. And surely your blood of your lives will I require. At the hand of every beast will I require it. And at the hand of man, at the hand of every man's brother, will I require the life of man. Genesis, Holy Bible.
Better is a dinner of herbs where love is, than a fattened ox and hatred with it. Proverbs, Holy Bible.
It is best to abstain from eating any meat, or drinking any wine, or from any other activity which might cause a brother to fall away, or to be scandalized, or to weaken. Romans, Holy Bible.
Then said Daniel to Melzar, whom the prince of the eunuchs had set over Daniel, Hananiah, Mishael, and Azariah, "Test thy servants, I beseech thee, 10 days, and let them give us pulse, or vegetables, to eat and water to drink. Then let our countenances be looked upon before thee, and the countenance of the youths who eat of the portion of the king's meat. And as thou seest, deal with thy servants." So he consented to them in this matter, and tested them 10 days. And at the end of 10 days, their countenances appeared fairer and fatter in flesh than all the youths who ate the portion of the king's meat. Thus Melzar took away the portion of their meat and the wine that they should drink, and gave them pulse or vegetables. Daniel, Holy Bible.
Do not be among those who give themselves to wine drinking, or among those who make themselves full with meat. Proverbs, Holy Bible.
Meats for the belly and the belly for meats, but God shall destroy both it and them. Corinthians, Holy Bible.
And you shall eat the plants of the field. Genesis, Holy Bible.
What to me is the multitude of your sacrifices, says the Lord? I have had enough of burnt offerings of rams and the fat of fed beasts. I do not delight in the blood of bulls or of lambs or of he-goats. When you spread forth your hands, I will hide my eyes from you. Even though you make many prayers, I will not listen. Your hands are full of blood. Wash yourselves, make yourselves clean. Remove the evil of your doings from before my eyes. Cease to do evil. Isaiah, Holy Bible.
This shall be perpetual ordinance for your descendants wherever they may dwell. You shall not eat any fat or any blood. Leviticus, Holy Bible. Blood meaning flesh.
Speak unto the children of Israel, saying, ye shall eat no manner of fat, of ox, or of sheep, or of goat. Leviticus, Holy Bible.
The fat of an animal that dies of itself, and the fat of one that is torn by beasts, may be put to any other use, but on no account shall you eat it. Leviticus, Holy Bible.
Moreover, ye shall eat no manner of blood, whether it be of fowl or of beast, in any of your dwellings. Leviticus, Holy Bible.
And whatsoever man there be of the house of Israel, or of the strangers that sojourn among you, that eateth any manner of blood, I will even set my face against that soul that eateth blood, and will cut him off from among his people. Leviticus, Holy Bible.
Therefore I have said to the people of Israel, no person among you shall eat blood, neither shall any stranger who sojourns among you eat blood. Leviticus, Holy Bible.
For the life of every creature is the blood of it. Therefore I have said to the people of Israel, you shall not eat the blood of any creature, for the life of every creature is its blood. Whoever eats it shall be cut off. Leviticus, Holy Bible.
Ye shall not eat anything with the blood. Leviticus, Holy Bible.
He who slaughters an ox is like him who kills a man. Isaiah, Holy Bible.
Master, also the Pope Francis, he's been doing a remarkable job in helping the U.S. and Cuba relationship and reopening ties together, which leads to the next good news that after 50 years, these two neighboring countries have agreed to restore full diplomatic relations and have started to ease travel and trade restrictions.
Yeah, I heard that. And they even went to Sri Lanka, where it's not a lot of Christian, but we went there. It's a good part. Good for the Christian people. Good for Christians. Good for the world. Everybody do their part. Wonderful.
Thank you very much, Master.
Oh, for what?
Just bringing your blessing to the world, Master, and uplifting our planet. We're seeing signs of it everywhere.
Good. Good that you're not blind. Some people are not just blind, but deaf. God keeps telling them, angel keeps telling them they don't listen. And I keep telling them in human language also they don't listen. I don't know whom will they listen. The truth like that. Any more questions, love?
Master, more good news.
Yeah?
In India, Palitana, a holy city for Jains, has been declared a meat-free zone by the Gujarat state government. So they have banned, they have banned animal slaughter, fishing, and the sale of meat and eggs. So they joined several other Indian cities, such as Rishikesh, which have banned meat, Master. So it's very beautiful news.
We go there. What's the name of the city? What's the name of the city again?
Palidana, Master. Palidana in Gujarat. It's in southern Gujarat,
Master.
Gujarat state.
Jai Gujarat. Jai Gujarat. Jai Gujarat.
Yes, Master.
It would be a very beautiful energy to live in such an area, my God, man. These people who live there are so lucky, so blessed.
Oh, yes.
My God. I don't know how many more cities will be like that, but it better be soon to save this beautiful world. Then the world will not be hell anymore, but heaven.
Most definitely, Master.
My God. India should be the first country to be whole vegetarian, or vegan, at least vegetarian. No meat, no eggs. Oh, wonderful. India should be all, the whole country should be, because it's supposed to be a holy land.
Yes, Master.
Yeah, life after life. Many masters went there to study. You know, and they keep the lineage alive so that the master can continue to come back and, you know, derive some, recover some of the city, to continue the lineage, you see. Yeah. Even Jesus went there, in his early days, young days. Okay.
Master, another good news from South Asia. According to news reports, the new Sri Lankan president, Maithripala Sirisena, is a strict vegetarian and doesn't smoke or drink alcohol.
Wow. Wonderful.
So another world leader who's embraced the clean way of living.
Smoking bans save lives.
Quitting smoking and restricting alcohol consumption, along with more exercise and higher fruit and vegetable intake, reduces the risk of strokes by more than half.
United Kingdom's ban on smoking in public places reduces passive smoke effects, which are linked to loss of life for more than 11,000 people every year. In the U.S., the Substance Abuse and Mental Health Services Administration said that sales of tobacco to underage youth have reached all-time lows in all 50 states. The number of young smokers aged 18 to 29 has fallen by 30% in Victoria, Australia, thanks to smoking bans in pubs and clubs. Smoking rates in Japan have been declining since 1996. Smoking bans mean decreases in acute coronary syndrome.
A study in Mississippi, USA, found that heart attacks were reduced by 27% 3 years after indoor smoking was banned, with similar bans in 11 other worldwide locations also showing a reduction in both heart attacks and heart disease.
Rome, Italy experienced an 11.2% decrease in acute coronary events in the first year after a smoking ban in public places went into effect. Israeli researchers report that for people who are able to stop smoking, the increased risk of sudden cardiac death seems to disappear immediately. The National Sanitary Institute in France announced a significant decrease in heart attack rates following the country's smoking ban, with benefits also noted for decrease in secondhand smoke inhalation effects. New York, USA experienced an 8% decline in hospital admissions for acute myocardial infarction after a comprehensive smoking ban, which translates into healthcare savings of $56 million US in 1 year. Smoking bans mean better health.
A U.S. medical study finds that quitting smoking has nearly immediate benefits, including lowered blood pressure and reduced heart attack risk within 24 hours.
Data from the National Population Health Survey shows those who smoke have higher rates of chronic conditions, such as bronchitis, asthma, and high blood pressure. Smokers and those exposed to secondhand smoke develop colon cancer about 7 years earlier than non-smokers. Smoking bans mean healthier children. Research from the Michigan State University in the USA and the David Hyde Asthma and Allergy Research Center in the UK show that the smoking habits of mothers during pregnancy increase asthma risks in some children. Children regularly exposed to secondhand smoke have more than triple the risk of lung cancer, as well as higher risks of other respiratory problems later in life. Smoking bans are good for business. In his annual report, UK Chief Medical Officer Liam Donaldson said a public smoking ban would save an estimated £2.7 billion. £680 million saved by having a healthier and more efficient workforce. £140 million saved through fewer sick days. £430 million saved from productivity loss from smoking on the job. £100 million saved from cleanup costs related to cigarette smoking. Plus more. For more information, please visit www.suprememastertv.com/harms-benefits-flyer.
Yeah, but I think Kerry of America, he's also a vegetarian, right?
Oh, John Kerry Master, the Secretary of State?
Yeah?
I'm not sure.
I don't know.
Oh, Master Dennis Kucinich, a former U.S. congressman, also was a presidential candidate, is a vegan.
Yeah.
John Kerry, I'm not sure about.
Oh, I see. I thought somebody told me that. Mr. Kucinich, right?
Kucinich, yes.
Yeah, his wife also. He has a beautiful wife. They're both vegan.
Yes, she works with Dr. Neil Bernard, the Physicians Committee for Responsible Medicine, or at least she has.
I think we should vote for a vegan president for a change in America. You know, it will help the country.
Oh, we'd love it, Master.
Yeah. How about vote for me as a vegan president?
Oh, yes. Number one vote. President of the world, Master. President of the world.
Yeah, vote for me. President of the world, yeah. You bet.
And the universe.
You bet. Yeah.
So, Master, from events like these that we've just discussed, we can see that the world is getting better, thanks to God's grace and thanks to you, Master.
Yes, but the screening is still going on.
Yes, Master. Yes, Master.
Because even though we have some little war going on here and there, you know, the little group of people and group of warring here and there, but it's still not a big war, yeah? And the reason is very sad, but if people don't change, they will be screened out in different ways, you know, in disaster or in accidents or even in war. We have to change quick. We have to stop killing animals. Of killing each other, then it's very quick the world will become heaven. Very simple. There's not much to do. Just be vegan, make peace. That's it.
Very simple, Master. Very, very simple.
Yes. Just to replace a piece of meat with a piece of vegan protein. The same. It's just protein. It tastes even better, healthier. Everybody knows that. Why don't they just do it? So simple. Replace a piece of meat with a piece of tofu, a piece of vegan cheese, a piece of vegan sausage, vegan fish, vegan shrimp, vegan steaks, vegan hamburger, everything you can replace. It tastes delicious. More energy, more healthy, and more clear in the mind, and more peaceful meat.
Yes, Master.
Some of the benefits of a vegetarian diet: lowers blood pressure, lowers cholesterol levels, reduces type 2 diabetes, prevents stroke conditions, reverses atherosclerosis, reduces heart disease risk 50%, reduces heart surgery risk 80%, prevents many forms of cancer, stronger immune system, increases life expectancy up to 15 years, higher IQ, saves 70% of a total cost of $40 trillion for reducing global warming, uses 4.5 times less land to grow food, conserves up to 70% clean water, saves 80% of the cleared Amazonian rainforest from animal grazing, a solution for world hunger, free up 3.4 billion hectares of land, free up 760 million tons of grain every year, half the world's grain supply, consumes 1/3 fossil fuels of those used for meat production, reduces pollution from untreated animal waste, maintains cleaner air, saves 4.5 tons of emissions per U.S. household per year, stop 80% of global warming, plus more. Save your life. Be veg. Go green. For more urgent information, please visit www.suprememastertv.com/beveg.
Just now, before I forgot, you guys say you wanna could come to see me, but you are busy then, no?
Oh, we'd love to come see you, Master.
how do we do this?
As you wish, Master. We'd love to come anytime. Love to come.
Okay. You know I live in the hut, right?
Oh, no. We don't mind. We certainly don't mind.
No, but you don't have a room in my hut.
We can stay outside, Master. We don't mind.
But just where do you sit? You probably have to bring tents.
Yeah, we can bring a tent. We can bring tents. We're fine.
There is a house and nearby with a couple of rooms. But the dogs, if you go, you will see dogs, the beds, and dogs, huts, and dogs, lounge, and dogs, toys everywhere in every room.
Oh, we all love dogs, Master. We love dogs.
Well, we can manage. Yeah. Yeah. But how long can you guys stay because of the work, huh? I would also love to see you.
We can make arrangements. We can take turns, Master. We can take turns.
I see somebody has to be there, right?
Yes.
Whoa. What is that, you know? Wow. Minza, I love you. You are good, Minza. Wow.
Wow.
Wow. I mean, good appetite. Wow. I mean, are you hungry? Yes. Wow. My God. I will say to you, hey, me, woo. Okay. And if you ask, do you love me, you say, wow, woo, woo.
Wow, woo, woo.
Yeah. You love me?
Wow.
Yeah. Wow is W-O-W. And woo is W-U and with the yohoi. Question mark. Stop. Yeah. And wu is W-U with the apostrophe on top.
Ah.
Like we have the move. Yosha. Okay. Wow.
Wow.
Wow. Yeah, well, like human language, not like that. He talk like, wow, wow, wow. He sings. I can't. He do. It's so beautiful. He sings so nice. Yeah. I haven't seen a dog who sing like that before. All my five dogs, no one sing like that.
Ah, it's an amazing dog.
No one like that. Huh? He's so endearing.
Oh, he must be a beautiful dog, love. He must be amazing.
Yeah, he is.
Beautiful.
I keep telling him every day, you're such a beautiful boy. Wonderful boy. You're my boy and I love you. And he was a whoop. Mean yes. Mean right. Yeah. What a humble dog. Praising himself, huh? Okay, what else? Anything else you want me to know?
Master, that was a sample of the good news that we prepared to share for today.
Good news. No more questions.
Yes, that we have finished, Master. In the good news.
Uh-huh. No more after-thought questions, either.
No more after-thought questions, Master.
After-thought, Master could say that, and what about this?
Master,
okay,
yes.
Yeah.
Actually, we would like to look forward to all the good news still to come, and we'd also like to invite you to share any wishes you may have for the new year.
Ah, well, I wish we had a vegan world and a peaceful world. I told the moon that. Whenever I see new moon, people say, when there's a new moon, you can wish something and your wish come true. Whenever I see new moon, if I'm outside, I see it. And I tell the moon that I have no one else here to tell. So I wish everyone would reconsider peaceful solutions, reconsider vegan diet. To make this, be vegan. Very simple. Be vegan, make this. And if you don't like it, you can make this and be vegan. You have choice. Two choice. Be vegan, make this, or make this, be vegan.
Yes. Thank you for your wise and loving words, Master. Thank you so much.
Okay. Thank you. Because you're loving. It's easy to love you.
Thank you, Master.
Be good kid.
Master.
Yes?
Master, we just want to say thank you for the love and the joy that you bring. Thank you for the songs of love and the many moments of laughter. And thank you for sharing your insights and sharing your amazing world with us and everyone. Master, you sacrifice your own happiness and comfort to bring happiness and comfort to others. It has been said that God loves us not because of who we are, but because of who God is. And the same can be said about the beloved Tim Kotu, Master, because you're the love of all the loves. And you always make our days sweeter, especially on days like today when we get to hear your voice.
Master, if we could humbly express our New Year's wish for you, it'd be for your health and protection, and may you always, always remain as beautiful and as wondrous as you are.
So be. Amen. Thank you. Thank you, all of you. Thank you. You're so kind. So sweet. So sweet. Oh, no. Maybe your wish come true, huh?
We sincerely hope so.
Yes, Master.
We love you, Master.
Love you too, all the boys and girls, beautiful and doing this job. Try to be cool, okay?
Yes,
Master.
Being cool doesn't mean you always do what you want, but do what is right. And resist what is wrong. That's being cool. That's very cool.
Yes, Master.
Yes, Master. That is very cool.
Yes. What else do you want to say?
Master, we'd all like to say to you...
Wow. Oh, my God. Now everybody will come down. I think you two become sane and heavenly beings. You have to be a dog. But it's fun, huh? It's fun, huh?
It's very fun, Master.
Thank you.
Yeah, my dog is so funny. He's so, so funny, so beautiful, of course. So sensible, you know? Yeah, so sensible. And, you know, whenever I meditate, if it's in a big and deep forest with maybe thorny stuff, then I don't want to bring him, of course. But if I meditate around the yard or around the husband, he always honored. He comes out of his husband. He walks around quietly, or he sits next to me. Now and then he walks away quietly, just check around, and then come back, sit there, and then go check around, come back.
Wow.
He's very, very protective, very understanding, very, very intelligent, very understanding in this aspect. He's so good.
It's wonderful, Master.
Yeah, I'm glad you have.
We're also very happy that he's there for you, Master.
Yeah. And, you know, actually he came from the fourth level, but he came down to the third level because of a request to be assistant.
Oh, wow.
So he's not so uncool, huh? He's cool. He's a cool guy.
We're glad he's there.
All right, love. If nothing else, then I wish you the best of the new year ever.
Thank you, Master. Master, all of us have something else to say. It's Pio 2, Master.
Master. Love you so much. Yeah.
We love you
love
too,
you,
Master.
Master.
We wish you all the best, Master.
We wish you
too
a great new year.
It's the year of the goat. I didn't know what year it is. So it's goat, is it? Yeah. Okay. Love you.
Love you so much.
Okay, here I come again. I forgot to ask you if you are well there, if it's too cold for you at night.
Oh, Master.
We're all okay. Fine here. And warm, yes, Master.
At night. It's supposed to be cold there, right?
Yes, but in fact, we all just got some blankets, Master, so we're very warm. We hope you're warm, too, over there.
Yeah. Well, it's kind of cold, but I have some tips for you, you know, like what I do, like, because sometimes it is cold air, and you might have pain in the joint somewhere. So if you feel not warm enough, then you can use the glass bottle for mineral water or juice, and you fill it up with boiled water, and then you tighten the cap very well, and you can hug it to sleep. I use just one bottle, and it warm up the whole night until the next morning even.
Oh.
Yeah. And when you sit on the floor to meditate, the floor, the air might be cold. You put that in between your legs or something, you know. Not next to, but when you sit, the deep one in and all right, you just put it there or next to your hip or behind your back, wherever you feel comfortable. And if it's too hot, you wrap it up first with a piece of cloth or the towel. And then slowly you open it when it's cooler, and then it will be warm the whole night. And then in the morning you can use that to drink, you know, like if you put in for a whole liter the whole day, it's just for you to drink water anyway.
Yes, Master.
Thank you. So you can use it to first to warm yourself, and then in the morning you drink. That's what I do. I just drink direct. I have rain water, you know, in tanks, and I just boil it and put it in the
bottle, and then I drink it the whole day.
Oh, great tip, Master.
Good. Because if you put it in plastic bottle, you cannot drink. But it's still warm. It can warm you up, it's just you can't drink. When something hot put in a plastic, it's better you not drink, because the plastic sometimes leaks into your food or your drink when it's hot. Okay, that's it. That's them.
Thank you for sharing, Master.
Thank you for your love and caring, Master.
No, I wish I could take care of you more. I'm just helpless because I'm alone and so many things.
Oh, Master, you do so much for us already. Please do take care of yourself.
Sometimes I forgot to take care of myself also. I don't know when my birthday, I forgot to have more blankets. But when I have time, then slowly I think about it, and then I can be also.
Oh, Master, we wish you'll always be warm as the warmth you bring to all of our hearts.
It's okay. It's okay, actually. I'm very lucky already. I have everything I ever need. Everything. But sometimes I love to see some of you guys, you know, like some of the old friends in the old times when I first came out in my mission. Some of you that I know over the years. Some of you I know through television. I do like to see some of you.
So touching, Master.
You know, we have the same direction. We look in the same direction. And it's very comfortable to be with people like that. That's why you're happy with each other, no? Are you?
Yes, Master.
Master.
Yeah. I'm also happy to talk to you, not just you talking to me. Not just you are happy to talk to me. Likewise, okay?
Yes, Master.
Yes, Master.
You,
Master. We're very
just
happy.
Just wanted to know. Yeah. Very happy with you. Keep warm.
Master, please take care.
Keep comfortable. Yeah. Keep healthy. Okay? Ciao, ciao. Love you.
Love you too, Master.
Love you, Master. Bye.
Love you, Master.
Bye.
Bye, Master.
Coming soon, a continuation of the teleconference. 2 weeks after the teleconference, in her loving gesture to fulfill our expressed wish to know more about her daily life and meditations, Supreme Master Qinghai made a follow-up call to Supreme Master Television to further share entries from her spiritual diary.
Last time you asked me to read some of my spiritual diary for you, but I did not have it with me. I didn't think you would ask. So yesterday I took the old diary and have a look. I can read you some, not all, okay?
Yes, Master.
Yes, thank you, Master.
On the 11th of October, I wrote that total peace could be more or less in 3.5 years.
Please tune in to this continued discussion with Supreme Master Qinghai, which took place on February 3rd, 2015, titled Be Forgiving and Merciful, Master's Diary, airing at a later date on suprememastertv.com. To be notified when the next part is available, subscribe at suprememastertv.com/newsletter.